Choices, choices, choices. Which should I pick? Between the OnePlus 9 or the Galaxy S21? Let's find out. Hey guys, Thunder E here, and welcome to my comparison between the OnePlus 9 versus the S21. And as you guys know, on this channel, we do videos like this, so don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also stay to the very end because I have a giveaway running this week. So stay to the end to listen for the full details. So the OnePlus 9 is finally out, part of the OnePlus 9 series. And I wanted to see how it compared to something within its same price bracket. I'm talking about the S21. So both devices are priced quite similarly. The OnePlus 9 in the US is priced at $729, and currently the S21 is priced at $700. Now in Europe, the pricing is a little bit different, OnePlus 9 being around $626, $650, while the Galaxy is about $750. So there's a £100 a euro difference there. So it depends on your region. But in the US, where I live, they are priced similarly. So let's take a look at what is different, better, or, you know, just the differences between both devices. Starting off with the display. That's the very first thing. Both of them have some really lovely looking displays in terms of just nit brightness. You're looking at a max nit of roughly around 1300, sorry. In terms of just functionality, both of them 120 hertz display, but the Galaxy S21 display is adaptive, giving you that flexibility of 48 hertz to 120, as opposed to just the standard display here, the 120 hertz display here, which is about 60 to 120 on the OnePlus 9. Display sizes are different. The OnePlus 9 is 6.5, while the Galaxy is 6.2. But again, lovely looking displays here, and it's great because they've got nice touch sensing, the 240. So those things you expect and love. Now, when it comes to batteries here, there is a difference in battery size, and that can be something that you should account for as a user. A 4500 milliamp battery on the OnePlus 9, while a 4000 milliamp battery on the S21. So in terms of batteries, you should be looking at maybe a slighter benefit with the OnePlus 9. I haven't done a battery test on them, but just letting you know what those differences are. And with that comes, of course, different charging speeds. Now the OnePlus 9 really has fast charging on here. It charges with a 65 watt charger that gives you about, you know, 0 to 100 in about 38 minutes, and a 55 watt wireless charging speed, which is great. While of course the Galaxy does 25 watts with its wired charging and roughly around 15 to 20 watts on wireless, which is nice, but definitely not as fast as the OnePlus. You're looking at least at an hour plus with the Galaxy, and you're looking at less than an hour for either the wired or wireless charging. Another difference, of course, is packaging. Now, both devices have two different size packaging. This is the Galaxy packaging here. With this size, you know, all it fits is just the device. That's it. OnePlus packaging is much bigger, and it comes with the 65 watt charger. So this comes with the device, which means out of the box, you would get the fast charging you expect from the OnePlus 9, which is great. So that is a huge benefit as opposed to the Galaxy here, where honestly, if you don't already have a charger, you still have to spend roughly around $20 to $25 to get charging for that. So that seems pretty cool. Now, we get down to the performance aspect of both devices. They both have Snapdragon 888 processors for both the OnePlus 9 and the Galaxy S21. And they both start with 8 gigabytes of RAM, and they move up, of course, in storage. Geekbench performance, you can see them side by side for both the Galaxy and the OnePlus. They're similar. The Galaxy might look a little bit less, but it's pretty much similar in that respect. When it comes to gaming performance, while you're using both devices, you're getting also similar performance in all the games. And again, you can check out my gaming video for both for details on that. But things like PUBG Mobile, when you're playing on the higher settings, Ultra HD or Smooth Extreme, both of them will give you an Ultra HD 40 frames per second and Smooth Extreme 60. Genshin Impact is also similar as well. I think the OnePlus 9X ekes out just a little bit more, but it's around that 55, 50 to 55 range.